Last year, AI 3D model looked like Play-Doh. And this year, this is what Tripo AI can create with its newest Tripo Studio update. Tripo AI just launched its game-changing Tripo Studio. Now everyone can easily create professional quality 3D models with just a few clicks. What used to take a whole team and weeks to complete, Tripo Studio can now do in minutes. It can not only turn images into 3D models, but also break them apart into separate pieces, generate different textures and materials, control exactly where those textures appear, smooth out all the messy details, and even make your models move, all in one streamlined workflow. I'll show you exactly how beginners like me can take a single image to a moving, production-ready 3D model, so you can have professional quality assets for games, 3D printing, animation, or any creative project. Let's get started. First, you can use my link below, or you can head to tripo3d.ai homepage, and here we can sign in. So if you're using the free plan, you should get about 300 free credits to try. That's probably plenty to try out. But to access the new studio feature, we can click the Tripo Studio button here. Once we're in, we'll see their highlights feature at the top. And down here, we have their community creations. These are some pretty cool looking models and they look so high quality. If we hover over them, sometimes we see this mesh finishing, and this one is segmented, this one's segmented, this one is rigged. It seems like it can dance. This one is rigged and you can see the skeleton inside. That means that they're ready to be animated. What really cool is they can also rig four-legged animals like this dog or even fish or this robot bird. So not just human. And we can click on any of these models to better look at the details. We can even click recraft to add it to our own asset and to further edit it ourselves. We can see that this particular model is segmented, textured, and the details that you can use to create your own project. I'm inspired, let's build something together. To enter the workspace, just click any button at the top, and then we will enter the Tripo Studio. At the top, you'll see all the core features, such as generate, have an overview of your model. You can segment or take apart your models and do further editing. We can do retopology to make the model more efficient. We can retexture the models, and we can rig the model so we can animate the movement. And there's also a stylization function where you can instantly stylize your model into a different style. And there are also two operation models on both sides. Before any editing, we'll need to have a 3D model. So let's first start with generating a model. Over here on the left, we can choose from two options to generate the model. One click does everything at once, model and texture. While Build and Refine lets you create the base model first and then add textures later if you want more control. You can generate models from text description, image to 3D, even upload multiple views of the same object to get more precise and accurate results. Also, a feature I find very cool is that you can batch create a bunch of different models by uploading a whole set of images at once. Then it will turn all the images into the 3D models. For our demo, I'm going with one click with image to 3D. And today I'm using this half robot and half cat girl I prepared earlier. And you can see down here we have a lot of customizable parameters. You can choose the style and decide whether you want to use private mode or public. You can create with their smart low poly feature to create something more efficient. We can choose from quad or triangle typology and assign the poly count. Decide whether we want HD texture for better finishing. Let's hit generate and see what we get. So we click the right panel to send it to the center of the workspace. I think this looks pretty good. Looks like everything is in place and nothing is broken. You click on the model, you'll see a draggable control where you can move things around. We can also use the axis to move things alongside X, Y, and Z axis. And on the right, we can see there are a panel of its position. And we can click the reset button to send it back to the default position. And down here, we have different viewing mode. The first is a wireframe mode. As you can see, this is a high density mesh right now. Second button is solid mode. It removes all the texture so you can just focus on the shape by itself. You can rotate, zoom in and out to inspect the model. And also we have collect. This lets you save the model in your studio library where you can find under assets, under collected. Share button lets you share on X, and you can also copy as direct link. Also, we can export or download, and there are multiple different formats you can choose from, including the ones that you can rig and animate later. And also, there's a print and delivery feature that you can purchase directly in Shopify. it's really cool. So you don't have to find a supplier if you're not familiar with those kind of platforms. Now let's check out one of the coolest new features, segmentation. This feature automatically breaks your models into separate editable parts. You can adjust and refine the individual segments or prepare them for 3D printing. Quick segmentation and you'll see the model turns into a unified color. And from here, we just have to hit start segmenting. So after a while, it automatically analyzes everything. You can see different colors that represent different parts that is segmented. And all the different parts are listed on the left. We can select the parts on our models, and you can see that the corresponding segment will be highlighted on the left, like this. I think the AI did well on the segmentation, but we can further fine-tune it from here. So let's say we want the hair to have the same color. We'll just click the area we want to expand, and then on here we get the brush, and we can adjust the brush size. We just have to brush the area where we want to add to the same segment, like this. If you feel like you make a mistake, like here I paint too much over to her face, and paint back the area where it should have been her face, like this. If you want to add a completely new component that the AI didn't identify, you can click this add button, add part button. It will actually add an additional part that wasn't there before. You can see here we are at part 44. And now we can use the brush with this color to add the new part. For example, we want this button to be isolated as its own part. Then we can paint it like this. Yeah, we can fine tune with different color. So now the button is its own part. You might be thinking this is too much work to paint things over and over. For that, we can also just press Ctrl and select the part like this that we want to merge together. For example, if I want to merge this jacket into a unified component, after selecting the part, we can just hit merge. So now the jacket is merged into the same part. And over here, when we click the property panel, we can see all parts here. Once we select the component, or simply just delete it completely. Remember to click save changes so the things that you edited stay edited. After segmentation, you might see the jacket line or rough edges where the parts connect. We can select the part and maybe press Ctrl to select the other part that connected, and then click part completion. You'll see that all these, the legs parts are selected. And then we can see that the transition and boundaries are all smoothed out and cleaned up nicely, like this. You can select multiple parts to do it all at once, but I like to select just portions of it to see the results before I decide that it will be a long-term change. If you want to go back to any of the previous steps, you can always click the history icon on the right. And here you can review every change you made that has been saved. You can also click the three dots to restore to the previous steps or save as a new model. And once you're happy with your segmentation, to save your changes and finalize the segmentation. On the retopology tab, we can clean up the model and make it run more smoothly. Let's switch to a wireframe mode and solid mode to see the mesh. You can see that we have a high density mesh now. It's great for detail, but they sometimes slow down games. So they got this smart low poly feature where you can basically one click optimize button to make low poly model. We can toggle it on and we can adjust typology and poly count if we want a certain result. And then just click retopology. And it is now retopologizing. Here is the small poly retopologized version. It keeps all the important details but have less poly counts. She can run more efficiently on the computer. And also a heads up, you might want to regenerate textures after this since they can get wonky during optimization. But that's what the next feature can come in handy. Let's try the texturing feature. On the texturing panel, there are three cool ways to change how your model looks. The first one is texture gen. You can either describe what you want in text, or here you can upload your reference image to retexture the model. And here I uploaded the original image I used to generate the 3D model. Under here, we can also find style reference. You can use their presets to generate textures, or you can upload your own ones. And for texture alignment, image align makes it highly similar to the original image, but it may have some 3D details variation. And you can also use structure align, which maintains the precise 3D structure better, but it may slightly differ from the original image. Let's try my original image and generate the texture. And here is the regenerated texture. We can see that it has subtle differences from the previous generation, but because we're using the same original image, so it won't be too much of a difference. Let's try their style reference. Let's try this makeup pop and see what we can get. I think this is pretty cool. It gives a completely different texture. Let's try Mecha. And here is the Mecha version. Let me try one with my own reference. Just download this pastel color robot and let's generate and see what we get. Here's the pastel robot I got from my own reference image. And remember, we can go back to the history if we want to return to the previous generation again, like this. So the second really cool feature is Magic Brush. So for Magic Brush, in this panel, you can generate texture review, describe texture details, and generate texture preview based on the current perspective, which is here. And then after the image is generated here, you can repaint the texture from here to here by smearing the area using the brush tool here. And then after it's done, remember to click Save Texture, and then you can apply the final texture to and exit. Okay, let's try it ourselves. So under here, this is a text prompt you would give in order to generate texture preview image in here. So it already preloaded this description based on what it sees on your model. A young anime style character with black hair, cat-like ears, robotic limbs, wearing a yellow jacket, black shorts, and large headphones with purple glowing accents. I think this is pretty accurate. And don't worry, it not only would take into account of this text prompt, it will also see the view that you have. In order to generate the texture preview, it actually uses both the text prompt and what it sees on your viewpoint. We can adjust text here, but I'm going to leave it as is for now. Down here we have creativity strengths. If you drag it to the left, it will be closer matched to what you currently have. And if you drag it to the right more, you will get more creative textures. I'll just leave it like this. Let's generate preview and see what we get. You'll see that it generates an image that is a little bit different from what we got here. And when you hover over it, you'll find this circle, which is the brush that you can use to brush the texture from the left to the right. For example, increase the shininess of the hair. Like that. And here under this brush panel, or transfer tool as they call it, you can adjust the brush size. For example, if we want eyebrow like the one on the left, we can just paint it over like this. So now she is more determined. And if we want the eyes of the yellow color like the one in here, we can paint it over our model like this to apply the color from the left to the right like this. And once you're done in this view, we can unlock the camera and change her over to other side, and we can generate again. We can brush the boots in a different texture. This is a shinier texture. We can click camera locked and just unlock the camera and flip her to other side and regenerate. This is better robot arm. Sometimes you get the color to the wrong place and you want to fix it like this. We can also specify what we want to change in the text prompt here. Let's try purple hair. And you may want to give it a higher creativity level so it can have more creative texture than what we already have. Let's generate and see. Great, so now we have purple hair. This side we can paint over our character to add color texture to our character. Does it look good? If we regret the change, we can just have our eraser and just erase what we changed. But this is just to show you how we can also use the text prompt to change the texture and then apply to our character. Remember to click Save Textures after you are happy with your outcome. And here's my final texture. I think it's really good. Well, to my standard, we also have PBR generator. Using this, we can create PBR material that will reflect better of the environment for authentic surface rendering. So let's try generate and see what we get. And here is what happened after the PBR material is applied. You can see that it reflects the environment light a lot better. Now it's time to bring our model to life with rigging. The rigging feature will automatically create a skeleton inside your model. It can move and pose. And this works for all kinds of models, like people, animals with four legs, fish, and birds that we just saw. You can click here to toggle the skeleton on to see if things are in the right place. And there are some preset animations here we can try. Let's just click and see if it works. And just by clicking a button, you can make her walk, run. This is her being idle. You can see the subtle movement, but she's not really doing anything. She's an NPC waiting for you to talk to her. It's pretty fun. You can make your character move. Under stylization, we can easily change our style by just simply clicking the preset style that they have. This is the Lego style, and here's the Voxel style, and here's the Verani style. This one is cool. And there will be more styles added in the future for easy restylization. Here's the pricing plan. They actually have a free plan that gives you 300 credits per month. Currently, Tripo Studio is open for the paid subscribers. The professional plan starts at $15.90 per month if you pay annually, and $19.90 per month if you pay monthly. And here are the different credits and details. Make sure to check the link and promo code below if you want to try it out. In less than a few hours, I now have a fully segmented, optimized, textured, and rigged 3D character that's ready for a real project. I hope this gives you a good overview of what you can do with your own 3D project. If you're interested in trying it yourself, don't forget to use my discount code MIAMIAO for a 60% discount on the professional plan. And also use my link for extra 500 bonus credits to play around with all these features. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.